fell heavy into your arms. These days of darkness, which we've known, will blow away with this new sun. But I.
Traditionally, when the groom sees the bride coming down the aisle, it's the first time, and it's the same time as everyone else. I would love to have a private moment before everyone else gets to see her. So.
Hi, Michael.
Hi, Michael.
Take thee, Shelley.
Take thee, Shelley.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
And fix my eyes. A tethered mind. Freed from the lies.
I, Shelley.
I, Shelley.
Thank you, Michael.
Thank you, Michael.
To be my wife, husband.
To be my husband.
To love and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
With this ring.
With this ring.
I be wed.
I be wed.
I will wait.
I had a word with Mike yesterday. I talked about guns. I talked about entrance wounds.
And exit wounds.
And exit wounds. And I talked about how to treat my daughter. Didn't I, Mike?
Sure did.
Mike, I remember as a kid, Shelly would always tell Mom and Dad that she would never get married and that she would live with them forever. This is true.
It's true.
Yes. I couldn't be happier that she was wrong. I knew the night I met you that you were the one for Shelly. As a big sister, it's a special feeling when I see the way you look at her, as if there is no one else in the room.
I wanted to say that all of us from Metropolis, we all wish we could have been here for standing in line and having the drinks and all that. But congratulations, Mike and Shelly.
I actually have to follow that.
After that trip, my two worlds collided. What a year we had. Shelly came up to Orlando all the time, and Mike, Shelly, Matt, Andrea, and I had more fun than anybody should ever be allowed. I mean, we got into trouble. Trouble.
Parents don't know that.
Well, too bad it's about something. This is the part where I take full credit for everybody here today. So, you're welcome.
So, Carolyn sits down on the couch and we're just sitting there drinking, and at one point, Carolyn turns to me and she goes,
I can see what's happening.
And I said, what?
They don't have a clue.
I said, who?